Good morning all. Today I will start module 2. The name of the module is basic concepts, modules and ports. So before going to second module, we just reminder the first module. What are all the topics covered in first module? So in first module, there are two parts we already discussed. So first part is overview of HDL and second part is hierarchical modules. Okay. Then in first module, we discussed about evolution of CAD. Then what is the popularity of HDL, why Verilog compared to VHDL, then what are the importance of HDL, then as well as very important one, HDL design flow, that is the belongs to what, a part A. So in part B, it's very important one, we have to discuss about hierarchical concepts. So in hierarchical concept, we discuss top down methodology as well as bottom up methodology. So we discuss what you mean by top down methodology and bottom up methodology, and also take some examples of top down and bottom up. For example, we have to discuss full adder, then 4 bit adder, then etc. Some example we have to discuss. Then after this, we discuss about module. It's very important one, because when you write any programming, that we always start with what, module. So we discuss module and instances, it's very important one, and as well as very important topic, stimulus block. Okay, once you complete the what, a design block, after design block you have to what, verify that results. So that can be done by stimulus block. So we take stimulus block examples, we have to write some examples for the what, design block and stimulus block. These are all the topics we already discussed with respect to what, first module. Then second module, basic concepts and modules and ports. So these are all the what, a learning objectives with respect to second module. So here this module is divided into two parts. One is we discussed basic concepts, another one is modules and ports. So here the first objective, understand lexical conventions for operators, comments, white space and etc. Some discuss about what, lexical conventions of for operators. So we have to discuss operator here, comments and white space. Objectives, once you learn the objectives, comments, white space, these are all the what, basic concepts, then throughout the what, syllabus we have to apply the what, this lexical conventions. So after this, the second objective, define logic values set. Define the what, logic value set. Example for logic value set is 1, 0, I impedance, don't care. These are all the what we discuss in detail with respect to logic value set, and also data types. Data types such as nets, resistors, vectors, parameters, wires, etc. These are all the what, a data type. Third objective. Then next objective, learn basic compiler directives to define macros and including files. So here we have to define the, that is special character, macros and some files in comes under what, a fourth learning objectives. Then fifth one, it's in comes under what, a modules and ports, that is the second part of the module. Identify the components of Verilog module definitions. So in first module we define the what, module. So but here we have to discuss in detail about each module. That's why here module definition we have to discuss, then such as names, ports, lists, etc. So here we have to discuss the module name, then some ports. For example, input port and output port we already discussed in what, first module. But here we have to discuss in detail about module definition and names and ports, lists. These are all the what, fifth learning objective. The next one, so once you study the what, a ports, next one is understand how to define the port. How to define the port in the sense, either input port or output port, or it may be a buffer or it may be a in out. Okay, these are all the what, how to define the port. Then after, once you define the port, the second one, how to connect the ports to what, external signals. Then last one, Describe port connection rules in module instantiation. So once you define the port, then connect the ports. So we need to work. There is a rule is required what a port connection. So that can be defined in last learning objective. That is describe port connection rules in module instantiation. So these are all the what objectives for the module 2, that is basic concepts, modules and ports. First topic of the second module is lexical conventions. So lexical conventions used by Verilog HTL is similar to C programming language. Verilog HTL is case sensitive. Okay, the case sensitive in the sense we should use a lower case with respect to what Verilog HTL. So coming to lexical conventions, so many lexical conventions with respect to Verilog HTL. The first one is we name it as white space. So white space consists of slash b, slash t, then slash n. So it means slash b means blank space. So slash t means it's an tab. So slash n means it's an new line. So these are all the example with respect to white space. So blank space and tab and new line. So many examples with respect to what white space. So usually in Verilog we are ignored the what white space. So we have to consider only for the strings. We are not considered for other operation. So in string operation we should use what white space for the string operation. Okay, that is the what a first one, white space. Then second one, comments. So here we have to insert a line or we have to insert a word with respect to a program or with respect to a code. We called as what? Comments. So in Verilog HTL, two ways to represent the comments. So one is one line comment. So one line comment is start with double slash. That is one line comment. So if you want another representation, that is we called as two line comments. So two line comment can be represented as slash, then star, then again star, and with slash. So in between this we have to represent what a comments. Okay, that is the what a second one, comments. So we take example for comments. A is equal to B and C. Okay, this is, you have to assume one line comment. Here after a semicolon, that is comment, this is a one line, one line comment. So this is the representation of one line comment. Suppose you have to write a two line comment, and that time this is a two line comment. So this is the example for what a one line comment as well as two line comment. So comment is classified into two ways. One is one line comment, another one is two line comment. So usually in Verilog HTL we are not going to what a two line comment. We have to concentrate only on one line comment. So next, move on to operators. It's a type of lexical convention. Operators play the key role with respect to what a Verilog HTL. So there are three operators with respect to Verilog HTL. One is unary operators, operator. Second one, binary operator. Third one, ternary operator. So these are all the what a
three types of operator. Then first one we have to define unary operator. In unary operator, the operator precedes the operands. Okay. Example, A is equal to, that is B, that is not of B. Here, this one is the what? A unary operator. This represent a not symbol or inverter symbol with respect to Verilog programming. This is the what? A unary operator, that is B is an operand. Okay, this is the representation of a unary operator. Then binary operator, example is A is equal to B C. Okay, B, there is an operator with respect to C. So here binary operator is defined as the operator in between two operands. So here operator in between a two operands. So here this is the what? A binary operator. Here there are two operands here. One is B, another one is C. So next move on to what? A ternary operator. So in ternary operator, here we have totally a two operator. Okay, two operator as well as three operands. Two operator is in between what? A three operands. Let us take an example for ternary operator, then you can easily understand what you mean by ternary operator. So example is A is equal to B C. D. So here there are three operands here, B, C, D, three operands, and as well as two operator. Here one is a question mark, another one is a what? A colon. So here there are two operators here, that is question mark and colon. Then there are three operands. So here two operator are in between the what? A three operands. Okay, these are all the what? A binary and unary and ternary operators. So all the three operators we have to used, we have to write what with respect to what in Verilog code. So these are all the what? Operators with respect to a Verilog one. So in number specification there are two types. One is sized, another one is unsized. So sized means here we have to define a particular number of bits. For example, 4 bit, 5 bit, 7 bit, 8 bit, like that. But when you used unsized one, we are not specified any size. So it automatically takes, it should be what? A 32 bit in machine language. Okay, so that is the difference between sized and unsized. So first one, we discuss about sized one. So sized format is represented as size base format number. Important representation, size, there is a what? A single quote, then we call it as tick, then base format, and then number. The size should be in the form of a decimal. Okay, decimal in the sense it represented as 0 to 9, that is the what? A size. Then base format, so base format, it depends on the what? Operator. Okay, so base format may be a decimal or hexadecimal or octal or binary. Okay, so that is the what? A base format. So base format can be represented as H or capital H, that is representation of hexadecimal. then when you write binary B or B, okay, small b or capital B, then you will represent a octal 1 O or capital O. So when you represent a last one, decimal D or small d. So this is the what a number that is base format representation, hexadecimal, binary, octal and decimal. So here last one, number. Okay, this number is depends on what? The size. Okay, if size may be 1 bit, then base format binary, you simply write the what? A 1 bit number. Okay, so number is depends on what? A the size. So number representation is 0 to 9. You can represent 0 to 9 any number, and A, B, C, D, E, F. So these are all the what? A representation of hexadecimal number. So this is the what? A sized one. Again, I repeat this. Sized format can be represented as size, take base format and number. Here the size should be a decimal number. So decimal number means we have to represent 0 to 9. So there is no other number, there is no alphabets with respect to what? A size. Then base format. So base format, you have to mention the what? Particular base format. So base format can be, it may be hexadecimal number, it may be a binary number, or it may be an octal number, or it may be a decimal number. So last one, number. The number should be what? It depends on the size. But number is represented 0 to 9, that is the decimal, or octal. Octal is 0 to 7. Okay, the 0 to 9 is decimal. Then A, B, C, D, E, F. So up to F, it's an hexadecimal one. Okay, this is the what? A sized format. So example for sized format. So first we have to take size, that is 8. So format hexa. So here you simply write A, B. Okay, it indicates it's an 8-bit hexadecimal number. So A and B is the what? A number. We take another example. 4 binary 1010. So here 4 binary, what? 1 is what? A 1 bit. Then 0 another bit. Totally what? A 4 bits. Next we will take one more example. 4 binary A B C D. So this is the what? Wrong representation with respect to what? A Verilog. Be careful, because here you have to write 4. This is the binary, that is okay. But here you represent hexadecimal number. It should be what? A binary number. Be careful about what? A representation of sized one. So here, one more advantage with respect to size representation is, here there is no case sensitive when you represent what? A sized number. So no case sensitive in the sense, here you can possible to write H or capital H. Okay, here also you can write a binary. Here you can write octal as well as decimal. So this is the what? A sized representation. Unsized representation in the sense, we are not mentioned the size of the number. Okay, so for example, we take directly, we go to what? Example here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So obviously you can understand this is the what? A decimal number. Okay, when you are not mentioned any number, any format, then it automatically what? A decimal number. Suppose you want hexadecimal number, and that time H A B C D. Here it indicates hexadecimal number of A B C D. When you represent a 1 bit, or it may be 2 bit, you represent up to what? A 31 bit. But in computer language, that is machine language, it automatically takes, it's an 32-bit number. That is the what? A speciality of with respect to unsized representation. X or Z values. we represent always small x. Okay, small x and small z. So here x is represent what? It's an don't care. So don't care means either it's 0 or it may be a 1. That is the representation of x. Then representation of z. So representation of z means, so it's an very important factor with respect to Verilog HDL. We call it as I impedance. Don't care and I impedance is represented as, don't care represented as x, then z is represented as I impedance. Let us take one example for this one. There 4 x are then a b. To take a b z z here, it's an 16 bit, 16 x are a b z z. So be careful about this example. Here 16 x are then a is obviously it's a 4 bit, then b is 4 bit, the remaining z it should be what? This is 4 bit, again this one is the what? A 4 bit representation. So here representation of x and z, it depends on what? Here base format, that is h, and as well as a size. Let us take one more example here. Then 4 binary 0 0 x. Okay, here you simply take 4 binary 0 0 x. So here 0 0 as well as x. So x is what? A 1 bit here. But here totally a 3 bit. What about remaining one? So obviously there is no MSB here. MSB automatically takes, it's an 0. That is the what? A representation of x and z values with respect to what? A Verilog HDL. So next, a negative numbers. So usually in decimal format, you can represent directly, you can put a negative. But here in Verilog HDL, so there are 4 formats here. The decimal, hexadecimal, octal, and as well as a binary one. So here some rules and regulations is required to what? Represent a negative number. So negative number is represented just putting a minus sign before a number. Okay, before starting a number, you just putting the what? A minus sign. That is a representation of what? A negative number. So here there is a rules and regulations with respect to what? A negative number. So let us take one example, then you can easily what? Understand what is the rules and regulations with respect to what? A negative numbers. So let us take 3 examples here. This is the one example. Another one. These are all the what? A 3 examples for representing a negative numbers. So here, this is the base format. Then before base format, there is a what? A number. Then after this, a number representation. Before base format, there is a size. Then after this, a number. So here, the minus sign should be what? A before a size. Okay. Then after this, there is a what? A representation of a sized one. Minus 6, tick, then D3. So here, it is the representation of what? A decimal number. Here, the minus 6. The minus 6 should be what? Is a 2's complement number. Okay, we can't directly write the negative number. It should be what? A 2's complement. That is the what? A specialty of negative numbers. So here, we represent minus 6 decimal 3. That is the number. Then second one, here, minus 6 H4. So here, this is a very important one. Because you can't represent in between what? A base format and number. You can't put what? A minus symbol in between the base format and a number. You just put the what? A before starting a size. Okay. That is the what? Very important representation with respect to a negative number.
Next one is underscore, character, and question mark. So we familiar with that word underscore. So it is represented as, why underscore is required with respect to Verilog HDL? That is the question here. So here, underscore should be what? anywhere in the what? A programming. Underscore should be anywhere in the programming except the first one. Okay, that is the first letter. Okay, that is the what? A speciality of underscore. So why underscore is required? Because you can easily what? Readability, and readability in the sense you can easily read the data with respect to what? IR bit. That is the what? A speciality of underscore. Let us take one example for underscore here. We represent what? A 12 binary. That is 1110011. So here you just observe the what? A 12 bit binary number. So 1110000111. So it's very difficult to what? Read the data here. Then it can be just modified differently. That is 12 binary. We split it what? In terms of 4 bits. So 111, you can put underscore here. So you can write 000. You just put one more underscore here. Then 111. So here this one is the what? Better readability compared to what? The first one. So that is the speciality of what? Underscore character. Next, move on to what? A question mark. So here the question mark represent a high impedance. So it indicates a high impedance is represent another word, that is a question mark. So why this question mark instead of high impedance? That is the question. So here let us take one example. This is the example for representation of question mark. So it's rewritten as 0 ZZ. You can add one more zero here. Okay, so these two are what? A similar here. There is no change of operation with respect to these two. There is a what? A similar operation. But usually when using a case statement, so case statement in the sense we represent case X and we represent a case Z. So you case Z. So using these operators, when you using this operator, and that time we are using a question mark instead of high impedance. This is the representation of underscore character and as well as a question mark. So next one, identifiers and keywords. Keywords is defined as, keywords are identifiers. So it reserved for define the what? HDL constructs. That is the definition of keywords. Next, move on to what? Identifiers. So when you consider the identifiers, there is a what? Rules and regulations for representing the identifiers. So identifiers may be alphabetic, okay, that is A to Z. It may be a numbers, or it may be a dollar symbol. We call it as S monitor. So this is the what? A representation of identifiers. But identifiers should start with either number or alphabets. Okay, we can't start with what? This one, because this specially what reserved for a task functions. That's why the identifiers is always start with what? Either number or either a alphabetic one. So let us take example for this identifiers and keywords. REG value, then input clock. Okay, this is the example for both identifiers and keywords. So here REG, that is we name it as register here in Verilog HTL, then value. So here REG is what? It's a keyword. Okay, with respect to a Verilog HTL. So here REG, it should be what? A case sensitive. That is a very careful observation with respect to what? A Verilog HTL. So REG is what? Case sensitive. So it means it should be what? A lowercase. Value. So value is an identifier here. So it may be a value, or you simply write another representation. This is the one example. Second example, input and clock. Here the input clock, the input is a keyword here. It should be a lowercase. Then after this, a clock. Clock should be what? Identifier. Okay, this is the example for identifiers and keywords with respect to Verilog HTL.
So last one is escape identifier. Okay, one more example is there, that is escape identifier. Then escape identifier is always starts with backslash. Okay, that is we called as a escape identifier. So escape identifier can be written as A plus B plus C. So this is the what example for escape identifier. These are all the what some lexical conventions with respect to a Verilog HDL.